चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानन्दा शिवद्वैत गौरवक्षवृन्दा Hare Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare
First of all, my heartily obeisances in the lotus feet of my Guru Parpadma Nitya Lila Pravishnam Vishnu Parsismad Bhakti Prajnan Kesava Goswami Maharaj. And again, millions of my dandat pranam in the lotus feet of my Shiksha Guru, Nitya Lila Pravishnam Vishnu Parsismad Bhakti Vedam Swami Maharaj. We have discussed Dhruva Charitra, Puranjan Upakhyan, and Kapil Devhuti Sambhad also. In all Charitra, it has been told, if a man wants to be happy, he should do bhajan of Krishna. Chant Hari name. This is Bhakti Yoga. But it is very rare to have darshan of any high class of devotee by which you can hear and then you will select your Gurudev, Diksha, Shiksha, and then Vishambhain Gurau Seva. By his service, we can have bhakti. The bhakti of Dhruv was not pure. It is called sakam bhakti. That is, he has some desire, though he accepted bhakti yoga, but by that he desired something worldly. So we cannot follow him. And by Puranjan Upakhyan you saw that worldly sense gratification cannot give happy to anyone. One day they will have to be old and give up this body, especially at the time of death, to whom you will remember, will have to come in that form. If you remember your wife, then you will be lady. And if ladies at the time of death, they can remember any man, or they will be man. If anyone remember his dog, then he must be dog. So don't keep dog. Now? Okay.
那么昨天我们讨论哈，苏瓦大清，还有呢是，普仁正这个故事，以及呢，和皮天乌吉桑旁哈，其中一些篇章了。那么在所有这些故事里面呢，都讲到了，如果一个人想要真正的快乐，那么他必然要从事呢，Krishna Bhajan，也就是呢哈，从事对Krishna的这个灵修服务。 唱诵Krishna的圣名，那么这称为呢Bhakti Yoga，奉爱瑜伽。但是在这个世界上，很罕有能够得到呢高等的联谊，让你能够得以聆听，并且呢去获取哈Shiksha啊启迪以及Shiksha训示，然后呢我们去从事呢对Guru的服务Guru Seva，那么通过对Guru的服务，我们才得以呢发展我们的奉爱Bhakti。 那么不纯粹的Bhakti被称为呢Sakandha Bhakti，也就是混杂有其他的世俗欲望。尽管一个人接受了Bhakti Yoga，奉爱瑜伽，但是他仍有世俗的欲望。但是终极来说，世俗欲望并不能给一个人带来快乐。我们终有老死之日。那么当老死之时，如果你记得什么，那么你自己得到这些躯体。比如说男人哈，记得他的妻子，那么他来世呢，或者一个女生。 如果女人记得她丈夫的话呢，那么来世得一个男生；如果呢一个人啊记得她的狗的话，那么她可能哈将呢投生为狗。所以呢，我们哈不要养狗。嗯。
In Bhagavatam, it has been told, Gita also, that what you will meditate at the time of death, you will become in form of that thing. Bhat Maharaj, being a high class Vaishnava, he left his wife, sons, daughter, and very big kingdom, and went to forest. But then, anyhow, he was in this stage of awe. Asakti then bhav, right? But at the time of death, he was remembering a deer and he became deer. His feet,
life,
were in hell. Anyhow, in his heart, but again he became in same state. How? Sriman Padmanabha Maharaj will speak Bhakti Charitra.
那么现在哈，我们就是在博伽瓦坛呢，以及在博伽梵歌呢，都谈到了死亡是属于一个人冥想什么，他即将得到哈这个形体，像布拉克大君，那么他呢离开了妻儿子女，离开了伟大的王国，去到森林中隐修，那么在那里他实际上已经呢哈到达了巴拉普哈这个阶段，也就是在阿萨提之后的这么一个非常高等哈这个灵修的阶段，但是在死亡之时他却记起了那只鹿，所以他呢。投胎为鹿，浪费了三世，在他第三世的时候呢，他才再次诞生为人。
Om Jnanati Nirandasya Jnananjana Shalakaya Chakshur Unmilitam Jena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha. So Srila Gurudev is continuing to bring us through the different cantos of Srimad Bhagavatam with the aim of teaching us what is pure bhakti.
这个他呢带领我们呢走过了顺典佛教瓦坛的不同的篇章，然后指出呢什么是纯粹的这个不爱 bhakti.
And as we heard from the story of Dhruva Maharaj,there is bhakti which is executed with material desires mixed in.
昨天我们已经聆听了关于都瓦大君的故事，那么他呢有这个奉献，他执行奉献服务，但是呢他里面混杂有物质的这个欲望。
But that is not pure bhakti.
所以这不能称之为纯粹的 bhakti 奉献。
Now in this story, in this history from Srimad Bhagavatam, we are hearing about the life of a very great king.Named Bharat Maharaj, who was actually a very great devotee, great Vaishnava king.
那么今天在这段故事里面我们将得以聆听这个伟大的奉献者，布拉克大君的这个故事。他实际上是一个伟大的国王。
And in fact, this planet Earth, is named after him, Bharat Varsha.
那么实际上这个地球呢也以他也是命名的，被称为呢布拉克 Varsha。
Bharat Varsha.
Varsha.
So, Bharat Maharaj, in his kingdom, he was vastly wealthy. He controlled all the lands on the surface of the earth. But yet, he had no attachment at all to his beautiful palaces, his wealth, his wives, his children. He gave up everything very easily, just as a person who passes stool goes to the toilet and leaves it behind.
那么尽管巴拉特大君的话呢非常之富有了，拥有了美丽的宫殿财富、妻子以及呢王国等等，但是呢他像拉大便离开这个肮脏之地一样铁锁呢撒手而去。
This was possible only because he had attained very high level of pure devotion to Krishna in the stage of Bhav Bhakti, as Srila Gurudev explained.
那么就像 Srila Gurudev 解释到一样，那么一个人要达到了相当高的阶段就像在 Bhav 这个阶段呢才能够做到这一点的。
At that time he had no Bhav. But when he went to forest giving up all, and he was doing devotion, at that time he reached up to Bhav stage.
那么 Srila Gurudev 指出来了，在他抛弃了王国妻儿子女 去灵修之时的话呢，哈，并没有达到呢哈八十阶段，而是在临终哈灵修修行之后的话呢，他才哈逐渐呢啊进达呢这个八十阶段。
So this great detachment arose within Bharat Maharaj, and he left his kingdom behind, and he went to the forest, and there, on the banks of a very beautiful river, he began to perform his devotional practices.
所以的话呢，哈，抛弃离去了哈，他伟大的这个王国哈，以及财富。那巴斯大勋的话呢，来到森林之中啊，在一个河岸边哈，在进行他的哈这个离修。
And gradually he became immersed deeper and deeper in his moods of pure love for Krishna.
那么逐渐他越来越专注于呢，对于 Krishna 纯粹的爱。
He was very diligent in his spiritual practices, and every day he would perform all of his practices of bhakti, such as shravanam, kirtanam, smaranam, etc.
那么修行非常之精进的哈，每日呢从事呢聆听唱诵哈，崇拜啊等等。
Smaranam,
尤其是哈，是 smaranam 就是冥想啊打坐。
So, the history.Describes that one day when he was in this beautiful forest surrounding, there was a deer, a mother deer, who came to that area, and that mother deer was going to be crossing across a river, a small river, and there was a tiger that roared very loudly and frightened the mother deer.
那么当时哈，在史书上呢描述到的哈，这么一个情景，布拉克大勋呢哈修行的附近的话呢，有条河了。那么有一日的话呢，一只母鹿哈，怀孕的一只母鹿的话呢，正要跨过这条河，那么背后呢哈，一只老虎呢哈，就咆哮着哈，追逐过来。
But the mother deer actually was almost full term pregnancy with a baby deer in her womb.
那么当时这只母鹿呢哈，已经呢就是说呢满就是。怀胎已经好快要呢，就是说呢，要出生了哈，这个胎儿。
And as she jumped across the river, this baby deer actually came out of her womb.
当他们哈因为惊恐而跳入这个河里河水的时候呢，这只小鹿哈就从他呢这个母鹿身上的哈就出来了。
Now she was lying on the other side of the river, and with very pitiful eyes, she looked at Bharat Maharaj, who was standing there witnessing this scene.
那么呢，这只小鹿哈，就是说呢，在就到了岸边了哈，它以呢非常好可怜兮兮的这个眼神的话呢，望着巴拉克大军。那么当时呢哈，它正在呢它的灵修的这个地方。
And then she died.
然后呢，这只母鹿哈就呢去世了，走了。
And Bharat Maharaj, he came there to the river, and quickly he picked up this newborn baby deer in his arms.
那巴拉克大军立即哈去到岸边了，那么就把它就是小鹿哈，刚刚出生的小鹿呢哈，就呢抱起来。
Now he brought the baby deer back to his ashram, and he began to look after the deer, feeding the deer the necessary food every day so that the deer could grow up.
那么他现在哈把这只小鹿呢带到回他的 ashram 哈修院里面去，每日哈供应他的所需啊，就是他需要的东西哈来照料他。
But as he was looking after this baby deer, he began to become very much attached to this deer.
当他呢哈照顾这只小鹿的时候呢，他日益哈变得呢非常的依恋它。
We see in this material world, people keep pets, animals, dogs, cats. They become very attached to them.
那么我们今天也看到很多人哈养着宠物哈，这个狗啊、猫啊哈，养的越久的话呢哈，就心里面哈越依恋这些东西。
So, but Bharat Maharaj is not an ordinary person, but yet he started to neglect his spiritual practices because of attachment to this deer.
那么巴菩萨君当然不是一个普通的人了，但是呢也因为呢心里面依恋依着这一只小鹿，所以他日益荒废了他的这个修行。
And he became absorbed in the deer so much so that he was constantly calling the deer to come, and he was cuddling the deer, kissing the deer like this.
那么他因为呢非常的沉醉于这只小鹿了，所以呢经常叫他召唤他，抱着他或是吻他。
And in the course of becoming so attached like this, gradually he gave up his spiritual practices.
那么也因为这种的哈依恋之心也好非常炽盛了，所以最后呢他完全哈放弃了自己的修行。
Then one day, as that deer was growing up, now he became almost full size. He saw a whole group of deer, and he went running towards them.
那么这只鹿呢哈就长大了。 有一日的话看到一群哈鹿群啊走过，那么他呢就加入这个鹿群哈离开了。
And Bharat Maharaj was looking everywhere for the deer. Where have you gone? Where have you gone? And he was lamenting and weeping for the deer.
那么巴拉普大君哈竟然呢会为这只鹿哈就是说呢哭泣啊，哦去在寻找这只鹿哈，说它在哪哈在哪。
So at this time, just when Bharat Maharaj was so absorbed.In this way, thinking about in separation mood from his baby, from his deer, oh, he met his death at that time.
那么巴拉普大君在这种分离的情感之中哈，在与这只鹿哈分离的情感之中的哈，遭遇了他的死亡。
Now, in Bhagavad Gita, Sri Krishna explains that when we are thinking of something at the time of death, when we are about to leave this material body.What we are absorbed in thinking about definitely will attain that.
所以佛家梵歌有一个非常有名的诗节提到了，当我们死亡之时，我们心意专注的地方的话呢，就是我们下辈子的目的地。
This is the science of transmigration of the soul from one body to another.
那么这是关于灵魂投身转世的这么一个科学。
Yam yam vati smaran bhavam tyajat yante kalevaram tam tam evaiti konteya sadatat bhava bhavika.So whatever mood, whatever power, whatever one remembers very deeply at the time of death, he will become absorbed in that, and he will attain that in his next life.
也就是说，死亡之时哈，一个人内心哈对生命的这个心绪哈，这个情感的话呢，在那个时候呢，他想起的东西的话呢，他下次的话就到了那个地方。
So Bharat Maharaj actually he took his birth in his next life as a deer.
所以最后的话呢，巴拉普大君哈投身为鹿。
Just like Gurudev said, if you keep dogs, then you'll have to become dog in your next life.
就像现在 Gurudev 哈指出来的哈，如果你养狗的话呢，你下辈子哈要变狗。
So, Bharat Maharaj, in that body of the deer, Krishna, by the will of the Supreme Lord, because of his previous spiritual practices, he could remember that he had committed this mistake in his previous life, and therefore, in the body of the deer.He wanted to always stay in the forest nearby to where saintly persons were.
那么尽管哈投身为鹿了，那么也因为他前世的修行哈累积的这个结果，那么这只鹿呢也是不同寻常的，它能够记起自己的前身，并且经常的话留居在呢这个圣人啊这个修院阿斯兰哈附近。
So he passed his life in this body of the deer in this way, and at the end of that life in the body of the deer, now he took birth in the family of a.Elevated Brahmana.
那么在结束了哈，他鹿的这一生哈之后的话呢，他投身了一个婆罗门哈，一个呢非常呢高超的一位呢婆罗门的家庭。
But because he was spiritually advanced from previous life, he could also remember that he had committed this mistake in that life as Bharat Maharaj, and now in this life he was very careful and he did not want to make the same mistake again.
那么因为哈，他呢是一个非常进步的灵魂呢，所以他能够记起哈前世的一些呢错误，所以他这次呢非常小心啊，避开哈在布拉托那君呢那辈子里面犯的错误。
So therefore, in this life, he is called Jadubharat because he pretended to be kind of like a dumb person, like a madman, that he did not have any proper mental abilities.
那么呢，这一辈子里面，他的名字呢叫加达巴拉哈。那么加达的词义，这意思的话就是迟钝的哈，呆呀，呆钝的、迟钝的，或者是说像疯子一般的。
Because he did not want that he would again become involved in material activities, he pretended to be this way, and therefore, although his father tried to instruct him in so many different types of knowledge and education, he would not learn that information.
所以呢，他呢哈假装成了哈非常的呆钝的哈，不想呢再去纠缠在哈物质活动之中了。尽管作为婆罗门哈，他的父亲的话呢，总是想呢给他良好的教育等等，但是呢哈他假装哈对这些东西哈不感兴趣啊，学不进去。
So therefore, after some time, his father and his brothers and family members they saw that he was basically a useless person.
那么过了一段时间哈，他的父亲和他的兄弟的话呢，发现哈他是一个废物一个。
So they gave up their attempts.To try to educate him, and they simply gave him a very ordinary activity of sitting in the field to protect the rice fields from animals and birds that will come.
那么，他的父亲哈，就是说呢，放弃了在教育他哈这么一种尝试了。 叫他做了很一般的活哈，比如说呢，看管哈稻田呢，哦，就繁殖的动物哈进入到稻田里面等等。
So in this life he was very happy because now he could become internally completely absorbed in Krishna day and night without any distractions from anyone.
所以这辈子呢，他相当是快乐哈，他没有任何的身心的完全的沉醉在哈在 Krishna 这种知觉之中，日日夜夜。
So one day when he was sitting there.In guarding these rice fields, there were some worshippers of the goddess Kali who came in that area. They were searching for a human being who was like dull, like an animal that they could sacrifice. Very evil persons they were.
那么呢，当时哈，卡利女神的一些呢崇拜者呢就在那个村子的附近呢。那么他们正想寻找一个人哈，这种人的话呢，就说像动物一般的人呢，哦，是很低等的一种人来做人祭。
So they saw Jadabharat sitting there. He was very strong body, very beautiful looking, but they could understand by his actions that he was like a dumb person.
那么呢，哈，巴拉普大君呢也在那个在场的哈，非常壮到，在地上壮到了。那么他长得哈，身材呢非常魁梧哈，样貌也很英俊，但是呢，哈，他的举重的话呢，显得哈非常呆钝。
So a few of them came and they grabbed Jadabharat and they started tying him up and leading him away. But Jadabharat.Because he was completely absorbed in the Supreme Lord, he had no fear at all, and he just allowed himself to be led by them.
所以呢，哈，他们几个人呢跑过来，将那叫他巴拉哈绑起来哈，把他带走。那么叫他巴拉因为沉醉于哈这个地主的这种呢，啊，不，这服务之中哈，所以他们哈就随他们的见哈，就让他们带走。
So they brought him in the middle of the night to this temple of Goddess Kali, and before the deity of Kali, they prepared him.To be killed and sacrificed in front of her.
所以呢，在半夜的时候呢，这些人哈、哦、把他带到卡利女神的这个庙里面哦，把他呢哈、哦、准备好，准备呢要啊、哦、祭祀。
They were trying to please Kali by offering a human sacrifice to her.
所以呢，他们试图哈、哦、将一个人呢奉献给哈、哦、卡利女神呢哈、哦、来取悦她。
Because in return they wanted to get so many material benedictions from her.
那么就是说呢，他想得到哈相对应的哈这个物质的回报。
But the goddess Kali was watching this scene, and when the priest raised his sword to cut the head of Jadabharat, oh, then amazing thing happened.
那么卡利女神哈，当然呢见证到了哈这种罪孽了哈这种发生了。当这个哈祭司哈准备拿起这个剑了哈，想把他头砍掉的时候，那么这时候哈一个奇妙的景象哈就出现了。
Suddenly the deity of Goddess Kali burst open and Goddess Kali herself came out of the deity and she grabbed the sword of this priest and she cut off the head of the priest.
那么这时候呢卡利女神哈从这个神像里面哈爆出来了，那么她把这个哈祭司的剑拿过来，然后呢把他的头给砍了。
And so many of her associates, they also came and they killed everyone there in the room.
那么呢，卡利女神的话，其他同游的话呢，哈，也通过来哈，将那屋子里面哈其他人呢全杀了。
Why? Because Goddess Kali is the energy of the Supreme Lord Krishna. She cannot tolerate the pure devotee to be harmed in any way like this.
因为卡利女神的话也是至尊主的能量，所以她不可能容忍哈任何人对她的奉献者呢，就是说呢有暴行哈粗暴。
But Jadabharat was very, very peaceful through all of this, and he was completely absorbed in Krishna.
所以呢，在这整个过程中，加德巴拉的话呢，非常的心平气和啊，他完全哈沉醉在 Krishna 之中。
After this incident, Jadabharat began to wander here and there, everywhere on the surface of the earth.
啊，在这个事情发生之后呢，加德巴拉开始哈云游世界。
And one day, as he was wandering in the public roads, there was a king named Rahugana.Who was being carried on a palanquin by four palanquin carriers?
那么有一天哈，他在路上行走了。那么其中有个国王哈叫 Rahugana， 那么就刚好呢，有人抬着轿子哈，就把他就过那条路。
So as Rahugana was being carried on the palanquin, one of the carriers became very tired. So Rahugana ordered that his guards should take anyone, any other citizen that they see on the side of the road who looks very stout and strong.And they should bring him for this service.
那么Rahugana这个轿夫哈，其中一个轿夫呢已经非常的累了。那么他就想哈，就在市民里面挑选一个哈身强力壮的哈来警惕他。
So they saw Jadabharat, and he was very strong. So immediately they came and they brought him to the palanquin. And Jat Bharat was in complete agreement. He gave no protest.
那么他们也见到了哈，加德巴拉哈长得很身材很魁梧的，所以呢就把他带过来呢，顶替哈这个呢教父这个位置。那么当然了哈，他完全同对在这种哈神的视觉里面，所以呢他也不在意哈，同意哈。
So now he began carrying the palanquin, but as he was walking, he was noticing that there were many ants crawling on the ground, and therefore he was stepping here and stepping there, and because he was moving here and there.The whole palanquin was rocking, and the king, Rahugana, became very upset.
那么他呢一路上走着哈，因为呢避开呢这个路上的蚂蚁哈，所以他走路呢哈，慢慢就是说呢，左摆右摆的哈。那么这个国王呢 ，Rahugana 在里面呢哈，就觉得很不安了，很生气哈。
And he began to chastise, all of the palanquin carriers.
那么开始责骂哈这些呢教夫。
And then they said, "No, it is not us. It is this new person who came. He is."Stepping in a very awkward way.
那么其他教父就说了哈，不是我们的错哈，是这个新来的人哈，他呢哈走路呢哈，就是说呢，左一脚右一脚的。
So then, the king began to chastise, Jat Bharat. Actually, in the beginning, the king was sarcastic, and even though Jat Bharat was very stout and strong, he said, "Oh, are you so weak that you cannot carry this palanquin? You're so thin that you have no strength."
那么呢，开始哈，这国王口气哈非常的这个哈，就是说呢，酸溜溜的哈，很讽刺的哈。他本来加个巴掌长得很壮的哈，他是说哈，你难道很瘦吗哈，很弱吗？难道这个轿子哈都抬不起来吗
？So Jat Bharat did not answer, and then the king commanded again, carry properly now.
那么呢哈，这个呢国加德巴拉哈没有回答的话哈，所以呢这国王说哈，那继续哈抬轿吧。
So as they moved along again, Jat Bharat was trying to avoid stepping on the ants.And the palanquin was rocking, and now the king became very upset.
那么呢哈，在一路走的话呢哈，也是的哈，这个加个巴拉图哈呢，为了避开这个蚂蚁哈，就是说呢，走路哈摇摇摆摆的，那个国王哈是非常的在里面呢，非常不高兴。
And now the king is very severely chastised. He said, "Do you know who I am? I'm the king. I can punish you."
那么这个国王就生气了哈，他就说了，他说你知道我是谁吗哈？我可以哈惩罚你。
So then, Jat Bharat, he looked at the king, and he said, now the king who was chastising him, Jat Bharat said to him, a very amazing thing.
那么呢，加德巴拉哈就对着这个责骂他的国王哈，说了一些哈非常的哈令人惊讶的一些言就这些话语了。
And he said to him, yes, sir, you are the king at this time, but only because of karma, because of the modes of material nature, you have taken birth as king.And I am your subject, but in any next life, I can become the king, and you can become the subject.
那么他说了哈，现在是的哈，你是国王哈，因为一种业报哈，也因为的物质自然的规律。那么呢，你现在贵为国王啊，我只不过是你的一个子民。那么来世的话哈，有可能我是国王哈，你是我的臣民。
And you have chastised me, saying that I am so thin and I am so weak, but actually, I am neither thin nor fat.I am neither strong nor weak, because that is only this material body, and I am the eternal soul within this body. I am not this body.
他说你说我哈又瘦又弱哈又虚弱，实际上的话呢，我不是瘦哈也不胖哈，我既不强壮也不虚弱，我不是这个身体，而我是呢哈在身体里面那个灵魂。
Now when King Rahugana saw how this person was answering him, he began to understand. Oh.This is no ordinary person. He is actually a person of great transcendental knowledge.
那么这个Rahugana王的话呢，听了他这番话语的话呢，哈，就觉得了哈，这绝对哈不是一个的哈，一个普通的人来的。那么他的话里面哈，具有一种呢超然的哈这种的智慧。
And immediately the king got off his palanquin, and very respectfully he addressed Jat Bharat, and he said, "Are you?" Dattatreya, some very great sage, coming in disguise like this.
那么呢，这国王立即哈下了轿哈，就像呢他就是说呢很恭敬的哈对他说话了，说呢难道你是 Dattatreya 哈一位圣哲了哈，乔装假扮成这个样子哈。
And he did his dandavat pranams to Jat Bharat.
啊，这样呢他哈这国王向呢这个加个巴拉斯哈敬拜。
And now he began to ask questions to Jat Bharat.
那么开始询问的话，加德巴拉这个问题。
I can understand that you are a very elevated spiritual personality, and you understand the true nature of the soul and how the soul is different from this body.
可是呢，我知道你是一个高超的哈这个呢灵性人物，你也知道哈灵魂跟哈这个肉体的区别。
But I have a question I want to ask to you, because I cannot understand the nature of the soul.
我有一个问题想询问你哈，因为我不明白哈灵魂的这个真正的品质是怎样子的。
We understand that the soul is different than this body, but yet we experience the pains and pleasures of this body.
然后我们尽管也明白哈灵魂跟身体呢是有区别，但是我们一直哈体验着这个身体的快乐和痛苦哈无常的变化。
And therefore we identify ourselves with this pain and pleasure. We experience this.
因此呢，我们哈去呢体验这种的喜乐了，并且呢哈就是说认同这些东西。
So it must be that the soul is actually connected with this body.
那么那肯定哈，灵魂是跟这个身体上有关联的了。
And then he gave the example that when you have a fire and you have a pot of water and rice on the fire.
那么他举了个例子哈，说呢有火，然后火上面呢放着锅，锅里面有米哈，有水。
So the fire is not directly touching the rice.
当然呢，火不能没有直接哈触碰这个米。
The fire is only touching the pot.
火呢只是呢烤这个炉
and the pot is becoming hot and that is making the water hot.
那么锅的话呢热了后呢让那水呢又热起来
and the water becoming hot makes the rice hot.
那么那水热了后呢就让呢这个米呢也热了
so therefore it appears that there is a connection between the fire and the rice.
所以看起来的话这个火呢跟那个米呢也是有关系的关联的
so therefore there must be some connection between the souland this physical body because we are experiencing the pains and pleasures of this body.
所以的话呢这个灵魂的话呢跟躯体之间一定是有一点关联的因为我们呢体验到了这个身体呢这个痛苦快乐。
So then Judd Barrett, he began to answer the king's question.
所以 Judd Barrett 开始回答呢这个国王的这个问题询问了。
And he explained, O king, actually, the soul is always completely transcendental to all the experiences of this physical body.
他说哦国王哈这个身体的这个灵魂的话呢永远超然于的身体的各种体验。
But we see that just like a person in a dream is dreaming that he is being eaten by a tiger, so he is, his body is experiencing, trembling and frightened like this. But when he wakes up from the dream, he understands, oh, this is only a mental concoction created by my mind.
那么就像一个人做噩梦梦到呢被老虎吃掉了，那么他也身体也震颤等等，长是这种惊恐的这种呢征兆了。但实际上呢，醒过来的时候呢，就知道了这个呢不过是心智的一个虚构来导致的一个感觉。
So in the same way, the soul is experiencing, but only through the mind, the soul is imagining that I am this body, everything connected with this body belongs to me.
那么实际上的话灵魂在体验但是的话呢也只是透过了这个心意的这个虚构了觉得的话我是这个身体我是这个心意等等。
And he gave another example of a tree on the bank of a river.
那么给了一个例子呢就是河边的一棵树。
The tree's reflection and all the branches of the tree are reflected in the water of the river.
那么树灯这个枝枝叶叶的都投射在这个水面上。
But when a wind comes and causes the water of the river to move in small waves, then it appears that the branches of the tree are moving.
那么呢，当一阵风吹过来的时候，这个泛起的波浪让这个倒影的话呢，这个枝叶的话呢，都变得摇摆不定，看起来好像这个树也在呢，在动一样。
But the tree is not moving. It is only caused by the reflection in the water.
那么实际上呢树并没有动而只是呢这个倒影这个变化呢是出现在它的倒影身上。
So in the same way, our condition within this material world is that the soul being absorbed in the identification of this body, therefore imagines that he is experiencing the pains and pleasures of this body.
那么因为呢这个灵魂的话呢专注在心意这个层面东西的所以他呢想象着经历到痛苦快乐。
So, Judd Barrett explained all these truths of the Atma, of the eternal soul to King Rahuvana, and King Rahuvana became very amazed.
所以呢，贾德巴拉斯向国王呢 Rahuvana 的话解释灵魂的真相啊，所以他非常的震惊。
And he asked him, Oh, great sage, really, who are you? What is your identity? I can understand you are keeping your real identity hidden.
那么然后的老王的话就询问了哈，哦，伟大的哈圣人，你究竟是何人？我觉得哈，你将自己的身份的哈真实身份呢隐藏起来了。
And then Jatvara told him, he said, you know, in your past, family ancestors, you have one king who was named Bharat. I am he.
他说你知道吗哈，在你祖先里面有一个国王名字叫 Bharat， 我曾经是他。
So then the king Raghuvana, oh, he was very thankful to Jatvarat, and he became a very great devotee at that time.
那么呢，然后呢，王的话呢也很感激哈，觉得 Bharat 这个教导他，后来呢也成为呢一个很伟大的一个奉献者。
And then Jatvarat, he began to explain to King Raghuvana that it is only by receiving the mercy of the pure devotee, and taking the dust of the lotus feet of the pure devotee and bathing oneself in that dust that one can achieve transcendental happiness and transcendental knowledge.
那么像Bharat 解释了，一个人只有急着纯粹奉献者的涟漪，沐浴在呢纯粹奉献者这个足下的尘土里面呢，才能够得到呢we can get the
transcendental happiness and transcendental knowledge of the soul.
超然的灵魂，超然的快乐和知识。
And he said, not by doing severe austerities and tapasyas, it cannot be attained by this.
那么并不是急着哈，这个 tapasya 哈，苦行啊等等这些东西呢，能得到这种。
Not by following varnashram dharma and the material duties of society, it cannot be attained.
那么急着哈，追寻呢，这个树林新兽阶层哈，也是不能够的，受持者不能够。
Not even by renouncing everything in this world and taking sannyas, this high truth cannot be attained by these processes only.
甚至哈，放弃呢一切东西，成为 sannyas 哈，也不能够呢哈得到呢这种。
Vina nayat padarajo bishetam. He said you must take the dust of the lotus feet of a pure Vaishnava and you must take bath in that. Only by this process can you attain pure transcendental love of Krishna.
他说呢哈，你只有急着哈得到呢这个纯粹奉献者莲花族的尘土哈，并且沐浴其中，你才能得到哈对 Krishna 纯粹的爱。
So in this way, the story of Srimad Bhagavatam tells us that we should be very careful in our spiritual practices and not make a mistake, like Bharat Maharaj had made a mistake, and we should be very diligent in our spiritual practices and not be attached to anything of this material world.
所以这里的话，这个教导呢就说了哈，我们在呢灵修生活中要非常的小心哈，不要呢哈再像呢，不要再犯了哈巴拉普大军哈这样的错误哈，就是说不要依恋任何东西，修行要非常的精进。
And another very important lesson, why did Bharat Maharaj become distracted in this way? Because he was alone in the forest and he was not in the association of other Vaishnavas.
那么呢还有一个哈要点呢，就是说呢哈。Bharat Maharaj 为什么会堕落后来哈，就是说呢变成鹿了，那么就是因为他是一个人独修的，周围没有任何奉献者的涟漪。
Therefore we should always stay in the association of devotees, especially the pure Uttam Vaishnavas.
所以呢我们永远要保留在奉献者的这个圈子里面，这个涟漪之中，尤其是呢这个呢纯粹的这个奉献者。
And one more important lesson is that at the time of death, whatever we are thinking of, we will attain that. But how can wecontrol the process of thinking at the time of death, we have to cultivate that during our life.
那么呢我们讲到了死亡之时你想这东西的话呢你既然到了那个目的地，那么我们怎么去控制我们死亡之时的思绪呢？那么就是你日常的时候呢去培育去呢培育你这种就训练它心意。
Therefore, by constantly hearing and chanting and remembering Krishna, like in this great festival, we're hearing from Srila Gurudev's lotus mouth,by this powerful process, our minds will become constantly absorbed in Krishna.
那么急着聆听唱诵和冥想 Krishna 哈，就像我们在这次这个大节日里面所做的，从除了固定要去聆听这些经典，那么我们才能够将心意的话呢，稳固在这种东在这种意识里面。
And by chanting the holy names of Krishna, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare.Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Then throughout our whole life, we will remember Krishna at the time of death and we will go to him.
那么你整辈子都能够记住 Krishna 的话，那你才能够去到他那里。
control. In the life of Bharata Maharaj, we should be very careful. And as it all, don't be attached to anyone of this world. Attachment should be given to Gurudev, and Gurudev will give this attachment to Krishna. Then you will be free from any attachment. Even don't be attached to your body also. What to tell others? Son, daughter, wife, husband, anyone. Then you can practice bhakti yoga in a real sense. Now, from endless time, we are suffering from so many things, so many problems, endless pain of endless birth and death we are feeling. This is not the first time. But as he told, Bharata told to Raghuvan, King, only by good association, high class of Vaishnava association, you can have pure bhakti. And in pure bhakti, name is prominent. Harir Naam, Harir Naam, Harir Naamaiva Kevalam, Kalau Nasteva, Nasteva, Nasteva. Only Harinam. Only Harinam and only Harinam. In this iron age, Kali Yuga. By this, very easily you will have bhakti and then cross endless birth and death, all problems, and have Krishna bhakti. In the life of Ajamil, he hears all these things. Can you tell? Oh.
所以我们看到了刚才讲到的巴尔普大军的仪式，这一辈子内饰的故事。所以我们要依附的时候，非常小心。就像刚才马德玛巴尔讲到的，不要依附世间任何人。我们只应该依附Guru，Guru的话会将我们的衣服交给Krishna。你这样的方式免于任何世间的依附。不要依附这个身体，甚至你自己的身体，儿子、女儿、妻子、丈夫。 而要在真正意义上去修习呢，Krishna、Bhakti Yoga、公爱瑜伽，因为无始以来我们都在受苦，无量的生世，受尽了无量的苦头，这劫非是，就这一世我们这样子的生活的，所以呢，也刚才也提到了，只有好的纯粹的 Vaishnava 的联姻，我们才能得到呢纯粹的Bhakti。那么在纯粹的Bhakti之中的话呢，以诵名Nama为首要的。 所以刚才呢，叙述的故事引述的话都是细节。在卡利年代，如果要获得救赎，只有唱诵圣名，唱诵圣名，唱诵圣名，别无他法，别无他法，别无他法。所以通过这个的话呢，我们将拥有 bhakti 纯粹的奉爱，穿越呢升起。<音>
Janjanasarakaya Chaksurun Miritanyena Tasmaye Sri Gurudeva Namah Sri Krishna Lila Ketani Sudaksa Madhoi Madhoi Gunaisya Yukam Varam Bhanindam Purusham Mahantam Narayanam Tvam Sirishanamami Mukham Kharidi Vachalam Pangum Langaya Tegidim Yatki Patamaham Bande Sri Gurudeva Tharini Panchikopatarubya Shakripa Sindhubya Vishapatitanam Bhavanibhyo Vaishnavedo Namo Namaha. First of all, I offer my most humble and respectful obeisances to the lotus feet of my spiritual masters, Divine Grace, Om Vishnupad, Sri Srimad Bhaktivedanta Narayan Goswami Maharaj, and the lotus feet of my well wishes and Shiksha Gurus, Nitya Lila Pravishnam Vishnupad Shri Shriman Gaurava Nuswami Maharaj, and Nitya Lila Pravishnam Vishnupad Shri Shriman A.C. Bhakti Vedanta Swami Prabhupada.
首先我向我亲爱的灵性导师送恩，去 Bhaktivedanta Narayana Goswami Maharaj 的莲花主呢，对你的虔诚敬拜。我也向我的灵性祝福者，Nitya Lila Pravishnam Om Vishnupad Shri Shri Govinda Maharaj 以及 Shri A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada 的莲花主呢，对你虔诚的敬拜。
And to Vidyanitha Sanyasigan, Brahmacharis, and the disciples of Bhaktivedanta Swami Maharaj, my Gurujan, all my God brothers and God sisters and guests, everyone, I offer my humble obeisances.
向所有在座的哈，提根地三亚地，向我的神兄弟们，向所有的哈白沙拉哈白沙拉的弟兄。In
sixth canto, Prikshit Maharaj is inquiring from Sukadeva Goswami about how the living entities in this very fallen and sinful age of Kali Yuga can be delivered for all their very sinful, bad activities, which is going to drive them down to the hellish planet. So what is the atonement for this?
就脱离这种将他拽入地狱中的罪恶行的活动中呢，解脱出来应该有什么救赎的方法。So
Sukadeva Goswami, he describes that for various impious bad activities, there are some prayaschitta, some atonements that are described in the Vedas, and they will counteract the effects of those sins.
那么呢，Sukadeva Goswami 也提到了，针对不同的罪恶活动的话呢， 给他经里面推荐了一些不同的赎罪的方式。
But what is left in the heart of the sinful living entity still remains the desire to commit sinful activities again.
但是呢，停留在这个罪恶众生心中的，就是说他从事罪恶活动，留在他心中这个印记，依然让他一次再一次的犯罪。
Therefore, he wanted to explain by narrating a very beautiful story how the living entity can not only atone and be delivered from sinful activities, the hellish planets, etc., but completely uproot the desire for material enjoyment and the desire to commit sin and ignorance that is all the anarthas in the hearts and the minds of the conditioned souls.
那么这里面就讲到了，不仅呢，让众生能够通过赎罪去免除这种罪恶活动，也呢，同样根除心中这个欲望。 这种想再次感官享受，这种心中的这些anatta要不得的这些恶习等等这些东西，想连根拔起这些东西，有什么方法？
So there once was a person named Ajamil.
那么经典里面提到了一个人物呢，就是说呢叫 Ajamil.
And he was a very pious Brahmin.
实际上呢，他是一个非常虔诚的婆罗门。
He was trained from his birth in Varnashram Dharma, the rites and rituals of the priestly caste, the Brahmin caste, and he was very expert at chanting Vedic mantras, and he was very pukka in all his activities.
那么他受训于呢，瓦纳什拉，就是说作为灵性阶层里面的各种的训练，从小精通于各种曼陀罗的唱诵等等。But
by fate, one day, he was traveling and he saw, by chance, a Sudrani, a very low-class woman, like a prostitute, embracing in a drunken stupor another man. And they were carrying on in a very intoxicated way. Their eyes were rolling and laughing and enjoying and singing. And Ajamil, this Brahmin, he witnessed this scene.
那么有一天的话，因为命运的安排，那么他在森林里面看到了一个出身很低贱的宿陀的女人，就是说喝得醉醺醺的，然后去 跟另外一个男的在这里面拥抱，又烫又笑，这种犯犯的行为。
Ajamil, when I'm traveling,
in Bardwaj,
somewhere, I don't know.
Sorry.
First I precise to, he was very high class of character of Brahmin, educated,
He has wife, children also. But he went to pick up some wood, and then he saw.
那么的话，他当时的话呢，就是阿姜密友哈，出生一个非常高贵的哈婆罗门家庭，也已经有了妻子了哈。就是说，当时呢，他是为了哈做祭祀，去林中哈收集一些呢食物去火柴哈，柴火呢回来。那么在这个时候呢哈，他看到了这个情景。
Krishna says in Bhagavad Gita, Vishayagini Vartante Nirahara Shadehina Raso Varjan Rasopiyasya Panam Nishmani Vartate. That even though a person may stop the engagement of sense gratification, still the desire for sense gratification may remain in the heart.
那么薄伽梵歌里面有个师姐提到了一个人虽然外在的终止了一些感官活动，但是内心中想享受这种欲望呢依然呢还有的。
So though Ajamila was practicing very strictly, due to this bad association, some latent desire in his heart to enjoy in this way also started to come up in his own heart.
所以尽管Ajamila的话呢强力的就极力的控制了自己的感官了，但是呢也因为呢他内心中这些欲望也因为这种不良的涟漪而被呢焕发起来这种恐惧的这种想享受的欲望。
Therefore, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he gives an important instruction. Asat Sangata e Vaishnavachara. One of the first duties of a devotee is to avoid bad association.
所以Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 呢在呢教导里面也提到了作为奉献者首要的一个任务就是呢放弃不良的涟漪。
And associate with devotees.
然后呢以奉献者涟漪。
So Ajamil came back to his home and trying to practice his brahminical duties, trying to control his mind, still he had some difficulties, so he was meditating on that lady, on that prostitute. And we know that by contemplating the objects of the senses, one develops an attachment for them and lust comes. So he did not control his mind properly and gradually he called that lady to become a servant in his own house.
He left his wife, children and everything, father, mother, and he himself went there with the lady. Bhagavatam? In house? I don't know. I have not read. I have not read. You have read perhaps English.But we have read Sanskrit. So you should know that this is the fact. How he can bring that lady with his father, mother, son, daughter, wife, how he can? And where there were so many Brahmin families, how he can bear?
Like a maid servant. Washing floor.
I will see.
那么当时的话呢阿姜密友回去之后的话呢他尽管还在旅行外在的还在旅行救援婆罗门的这些职责，但是他实际上心意呢控制不了老是在冥想呢那个妓女那么就像讲到的如果你心思感官对象的话呢色欲呢就会展示了，所以这时候呢他就控制不了自己的学的后面提到了他就跑到了放弃自己的妻子女家庭跑到了跟那个妓女去住在一起。
So due to the association of that prostitute now taking her as his wife, he begat many children, actually 10 children, and he lived for so many years together with her, engaging in all kinds of illicit sexual activity, drinking. He had fallen down from his brahminical position into just like a low-born sudra.
So the 话呢，哈，他实际上呢，将这个妓女已经当做自己的妻子哈来看待了，跟他生育养育了哈10个儿子，并且呢，哈，就放纵自己的行为了就沉迷于这种非法的性生活饮酒啊酗酒等等，最后变成了实际上呢从婆罗门这个位置上完全堕落成为一个呢低贱的这个宿婆贱民。
He had one son which was his youngest son and he loved him very much. His name was Narayana.
那么呢他有最后呢养育了一个最小的儿子名字呢叫 Narayana。
So because of so much affection for his son, when he called his son for prasadam, he said, Narayana, come, take your meal. Narayana, come with me, we're going out. Narayana, here, do this, do that. So he was constantly chanting the name of his son, which was also simultaneously the transcendental holy name of the Lord.
实际上英美的话非常的疼爱伊莲这个儿子所以他看到董事呼唤他呼唤的时候呢然后南莱燕呢后来不杀他们了跟他或者跟他一起出去跟他一起玩等等那么尽管的话他讲的是自己儿子的名字但是受小的这个名字呢也是自尊主南莱燕的名字
At a very old age, age of 88, he became old and death was coming to him. It was his time to die. So, at that point, the Yamadutas, the servants of Yamaraj, who punished sinful people in this world, came to him and started to rip out from his heart his subtle body and his soul.
那么呢当他死亡之时候就是说就88岁的时候年纪很大即将的就是说死的时候那么阎罗王这鬼族呢亚麻珠堂出来了那么就把他这个精锐的躯体和灵魂呢想抽出他的心脏
They're very fearsome, very ugly, they have long hair, they have big sharp teeth, and they're very fearful. So when persons who are sinful in this life approach death, they have an opportunity to see these personalities coming to take them to the court of Yamaraj where they'll be judged and then sent to various hellish planets to prepare for their next life.
那么呢这些亚麻珠草的话呢面目狰狞长得獠牙这个牙齿很胖的所以呢任何一个呢就说呢罪行罪孽深重的人呢那么在死亡之时呢有机会呢见到呢阎罗王这个鬼族的鬼胎将被拖到这个阎罗王的这个法庭上呢宣判他们下世到哪个地方去承受他们这个罪业
So by Adamiel's good fortune, at that time, thinking of what was most important to him, his dear son, his youngest son, he called out, Narayan! Narayan! Thinking of his son.
那么呢在马加密因为他的幸运了那么在那个死亡之时他记起了自己的儿子然后在呼唤他的名字 Narayan! Narayan!
So people in this world, at the time of death, they generally think of what we do our entire life. And those activities, relationships, attachments, affections that we have that are most important to us, those pictures and those thoughts, they come into our mind at the time of death.
所以一般普通的人的话呢他们这辈子里面所经历的东西所做的活动所拥有的关系等等这些东西的话呢在他死亡时候在记忆都会一一道来他只记得这些东西。
Vedic culture is so nice that in Indian families, the parents, they name their children names of God, names of Krishna, names of Narayan. So this was the custom. And also Gurudev now has given, through initiation, many of you new names, which are spiritual names, names of Krishna, names of Radharani, names of Krishna's associates.
或是呢像主拿拉雅等等这些名字那么现在我们也一样在修行之后的话呢师父殿也授予了门徒这些不同的名字很多名字呢都是 Krishna Radharani 等等这些灵性同游的名字
So just by saying one's own name or someone else calling us by our spiritual name then there's so much benefit to that spiritual benefit
所以呢当我们说自己的名字或是别人称叫我们的名字的时候呢都有很多灵性的这些益处
So at this time, even though the Yamadutas came to punish Adamiel, because he called the name of the Lord Narayan, Narayan or Vishnu's own servants came, the Vishnu Dutas, and they appeared there in a very wonderful glowing form.
所以呢出于恐惧在呼唤这个Narayan这个名字所以呢属Narayan的这个使者的话呢Vishnu Dutas就来了。Narayan support
Vedas became fourth past Vishnu Dut and they came. And also Narayana. They were all four handed.
Krishna.
Ram also, Ramo, 200. Nrisimha, Nrisimha, so many. So he's thousands of
hands.
That's Lord.
Krishna 的话就他们就补充了一下 ，Krishna 有两个音节，然后所以呢，他有双臂的形象，像主 Rama 也是双臂形象，但是你现在这也只能好有呢，树的话。
So they were stopped by the Vishnu-dutas. Vishnu-dutas said, stop, you should not take this living being. And the Yama-dutas, they said, this person is very sinful. His life, he's committed so many sins. How can you stop us?
那么呢,这个Vishnu-dutas,就天使的话呢,就阻止了这鬼族,就说你不能够带走他们。但是呢,Yama-dutas... 亚马都塔就说了，他说呢，这个人罪孽深重，一定要带走他的。So
the Vishnu Dutas then they began to explain that even though Ajamil had committed so many sinful activities, because he had called on the name of the Lord at the time of death, and because so many times during his life he had also called on the name of the Lord, his sinful activities had been minimized and actually completely wiped out because his chanting was free from offense.
那么天使呢，Vishnu-dutas解释了，因为呢，尽管他从事了很多罪恶的行活动，但是呢，他死亡之时称呼神的名字，并且呢，在日常的时候呢，也经常称呼神的名字，而且这种名字呢是没有冒犯的，所以呢，不仅可以削减他的罪孽，直到最低的程度，甚至可以呢，完全就是说呢，他服他这些呢罪行。
He was committing sinful activities. But he was also chanting the holy name of the Lord unconsciously or unknowingly, only calling his son. So if a devotee commits sinful activities, but then chants the holy name of the Lord to atone for those activities, to try to free himself or herself from the sins of that activity, that is namaparad. And that will not do. So in this case, Ajamil did not commit this namaparad, but he chanted namabak because he was just innocently chanting the name of Narayan.
所以的话呢，尽管就是说呢，阿们阿加密一方面犯罪另一方面也有唱诵圣名，但是呢，他唱诵圣名是在不知情的情况下唱诵的，并没有冒犯，所以的话呢，他的唱诵呢，并不类似于呢我们一些奉献者我们唱诵圣名，但是一方面我没有去犯罪，然后呢。 希望呢，唱诵圣名能够抵消这种罪行。那么这属于呢，Namaparad对圣名的冒犯。那么实际上阿正念唱诵的是Namabas圣名的影子这种状态。There
are three stages of chanting: Namaparad, Namabas, and Sudanam.
那么我们知道呢，唱诵圣名有三个阶段有三种的类型，一个是 Namaparad 冒犯性的圣名 ，Namabas 圣名的影子，还有呢 Sudanam 纯粹圣名。
Namaparad means there are 10 offenses against chanting. One is chanting the holy name, but he does not think the name is Krishna, or he thinks it's a very pious activity, or he's committing offense to Vaishnavas, or not following Gurudev, or considering the name of Krishna to be equal to the name of the demigods, etc.
那么呢，唱诵圣名有十项的冒犯，大家可以回顾一下，包括呢，你唱诵圣名的时候，认为唱诵圣名呢是一个吉祥的活动，或者是呢，认为呢，圣名的话呢。 主的圣名跟像放神人是一样的，或是呢批评Vaishnava不遵守灵性导师训示，将灵性导师看作普通的凡人等等，这些呢都属于呢唱诵圣名的冒犯。And
in the Namabas stage, the second stage called the clearing stage, the offenseless stage, but not the pure stage, there are many different levels or categories. It may mean that one just jokingly chants or inadvertently chants, or in a angry way chants, or a devotee who is practicing Krishna consciousness, trying his best to follow and avoiding the offenses, but is not so developed in bhakti. And all these categories may be considered the second stage of namabhas.
那么 namabhas 这个地方的话属于清洁的阶段，就清洁的就是说谁呢没有冒犯的唱诵，但是呢还不属于纯粹圣名，包括呢有时候呢开玩笑的时候哈唱诵圣名啊，还有以及然后中间者在修习的过程中呢，既开好小心的避开冒犯，但是呢依然还没有唱诵纯粹圣名，等等这里面的话层次相当之多的。
All chanting awards so much benefit. Namaparad also awards material benefit. Namabhas awards liberation. And the pure chanting of the holy name awards pure devotional service, loving devotional service to Krishna.
那么冒犯性的圣名可以赐予我们物质性的得意、财富等等物质性的东西。那么阿巴可以给我们解脱的。那么苏达纳纯粹圣名可以给我们对Krishna纯粹的爱。
So the Vishnu-dutas had defeated the Yama-dutas and they had to leave. And the Vishnu-dutas then, they disappeared. And Ajamil, he got his life back. He should have died due to karma, but because of chanting, his karma was eradicated. All his sinful activities were eradicated, and by the mercy of Narayan, he got a second chance to live this life and practice bhakti.
那么天使的话呢，维斯诺多哈击败了这些鬼族了啊，亚玛杜萨，所以呢阿香米尔的话呢，尽管因为业报哈康马的缘故的话呢，他就是应该受限已尽的了。 但是呢，因为他唱诵主的圣名，所以呢，他的这个卡玛哈业报呢得到了修正啊，他呢获得了呢就延长这个受限哈，他继续呢哈继续灵修。
Ajamil wanted to say something to the Vishnu Dutas, but immediately they disappeared because sometimes the devotee is put into separation to increase the intensity of desire in separation. So this is what happened here.
那么当时呢，阿杰米尔呢还想哈向呢这些 Vishnu Dutas 说一些话，但是呢他们立即哈消失了。所以有时候呢，
When Ajamil wanted to speak to the Vishnu Dutas and say something, but they disappeared from his sight.
Why?
Because they wanted to increase his desire in separation. Plus, he had not developed his pure bhakti. Only has he had become liberated from his sins.
He has done only namabhas, but not shuddhane. A person cannot touch any parikar of Krishna or Vaikuntha until he is totally pure. So at that time, he has not chanted pure name.
Only to show the glory of name, they appear in front of him.
Only. So he could not touch, but in the end, when he went to Haridwar, and began to remember Shuddha name by the grace of 400 Vishnu Dutas, then he became totally purified. And then same Vishnu Dut came, and they told that you should come in airplane. We will take you to bed. Then he questioned, why at that time You are inviting me to come with you. Then he just told, now you are quite pure, you have love, frame, and now you can be with us, and you will be also parikar of Vaikunthana.
那么这里面有一个问题的，就是说呢，为什么阿杰密尔当时呢这些天使呢立即消失了，他没有机会呢得以呢触碰他们或是与他们对话。那须的规律呢就提到了，因为呢阿杰密尔念诵的是呢南无阿巴斯圣名的影子，而不是呢哈苏达那姆纯粹的圣名。所以呢，任何人呢如果他没有呢，就说任何人如果他不是呢纯洁的，他是不能够触碰主哈或主的同流的，所以他必须哈就唱诵呢。 纯粹圣灵才行的。所以当时的话呢，他下面并不能啊，他
2 minutes what?This is Bhaum Leela. And not liberated. Jai Jai Radharam.
Jai Harina Mahamantra Ki Jai. Jai Jai Radharaman Haribo. Jai Jai Radharaman Haribo.
Thank you.